Everyone, welcome to Drop of Divine Mercy. My name is Jude, and this week I wanted to share a page in our companion book, Jesus Speaks to Faustina and You, this wonderful book that I highly recommend you purchasing. It's published by Sophia Institute Press. And I was reading this week from a page that I think I'm going to go ahead and open up our series this week and share this with you. It's for August 17th, A Moment Lasts a Lifetime. Should you be unable to step into the chapel, immerse yourself in prayer, there where you happened to be, if only for a brief instant. That's the Diary of St. Faustina, 1572. The reflection for this day, while praying for an extended period of time in church, especially before or after Mass, is ideal. We aren't always able to do that. The demands of our families and our work may make praying in church more of a luxury than a regular occurrence. The wonderful news is that we don't have to be in a special place to pray, and we don't have to have hours and hours set aside. We can pray whenever and wherever we are, even if our prayers last only for a very brief instant. God is with us, listening to and loving us. And the prayer is, Dear Lord, in the busyness of my life, hear my prayer. Jesus, have mercy on us and on the whole world. So this is such a beautiful reflection and a meditation. And I had the opportunity, after I had read this particular day's reflection, to stop in at an adoration chapel, where the Blessed Sacrament is exposed, and spend some time. And when I was there, kneeling in front of the most beautiful sacrament, I felt, first of all, gratefulness for my many blessings. Each and every day, the things that maybe we take for granted, just the breath that we take, just the ability to wake up and be able to care for those around us, that we are able to have work and go to work, that we are able to share with others the good news. Just that one more day that we can maybe touch someone else and give them the gift of faith. Number two, this to me was an invitation to pour out my petitions for my loved ones, for those in need of healing in mind, body, and spirit, for the souls in purgatory, the faithful departed, as well as those who face persecution for the faith. Number three, I really feel a sense that I am home in church, that is a place that I feel safe, that I feel that I can totally be me and totally bring everything to God. So just sitting before the Blessed Sacrament, before my Lord and my God, is such a beautiful and deeply touching experience that I highly recommend. Number four, I, being in church at that moment, am uniting my prayers with all of the faithful, knowing that when we spend even a little time in church in meditation, that could be at Mass, during Mass, after Mass, or sometime during the week that we pop in to a church, there is a Mass being said the sacrifice of the Mass somewhere in the world, and we are uniting our prayers with that. We can look to our angels and saints for their constant intercession, on which we rely for unfailing help. Number five, I can baptize myself with the holy water as I enter. And in doing that, I remember my baptismal promises to one, reject Satan, all his works, and all his empty promises. Number two, that I profess my creedal faith. What were the things that I confess? What were the things that I live by? Those words that become actions and deeds every day in my life. That I have given my life up to Christ, to living a holy life, for striving each and every day to attain that holiness. And number three, to repent of our sins so we can offer our prayers and we can offer worship to God with pure and contrite hearts. Remember to carry a bottle of holy water such as this. This is available at Catholic gift shops or online. I'll link below a site where you can get a bottle that you can have blessed holy water put into, and that you can be able at any time to go ahead and bless yourself, remembering those promises. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So, my friends, let us close now with the beautiful prayer that we recite when we have prayed the Chaplet of Divine Mercy. Eternal God, in whom mercy is endless, and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself. So my friends, if you do have a moment now, I will link below the audiovisual video that I did praying the Divine Mercy Chaplet. And remember to always feel free to leave your prayer intentions below, and I will be praying for you. Please pray for me. God bless.